Welcome to MMA Inside the Cage. I'm your host, Cyrus Fees. Next to me, it looks like he's trying out for Duck Dynasty, Casey Oxenden.
Well, brother, one might think I'm a little grizzled, but you know, the only dynasty that's going down is right here on MMA Inside the Cage.
No doubt.
We're talking some of the biggest events from across the world, but also some of the most controversial combat sports that ever have existed.
Well, they say the controversy creates cash, brother.
That's the truth.
Absolutely. This week, it's a full preview of the Combat 8 card in Sydney, Australia on April 27th. A new generation of weapon-based combat and more. Let's kick it off with our world headlines, our MMA news flurry, top story out of M1 Global. Yes, they're still there. They're still going strong in Russia. They're not quite getting the same press since Fedor and Strikeforce, but this one just might. A new heavyweight Grand Prix, Casey, is going down. This thing is very international. Starts in a few days at M1 Challenge 38 at the Ice Palace. Big names on the card, man. This is huge.
Well, you're talking about heavyweight champ Kenny Garner and the big striker that we've seen a lot of in Draka. We're talking about Konstantin Bluhoff.
Just to name a few. And then you throw a couple up-and-comers like Rodrigo Baidoo from Brazil, and then Magomed Malikov, Alexei Kudin from Belarus. Man, this is a truly international event. Going to be great. Check out m1global.com for more information. We're going to have highlights next week right here on this show. AFC, the Australian Fighting Championship, has released their full card for the AFC 5 event on May 10th in Melbourne. It's going to be live on epicenter.tv. This one's going to be solid from top to bottom. Casey, we already know about the two tournaments. Now they put some names on this one in the welterweight and the middleweight tournaments. You got a guy like Daniel Kelly, who we saw in the fight of the year last year with Fabio Galeb. He's on one side. And then you have a guy, Playboy Borbatovs from WFC, on the other side of the bracket. Some really big matchups. And imagine if they get together.
Well, I can't wait to see Daniel Kelly back in action. This is an Olympic judo champion, my man.
No doubt.
When he gets back in there, I can't wait to see him throw down, man. It was probably the best fight I've ever seen in my entire life. And of course, Borbatov, what can you say, man? This is Sligo's hired gun from all the way there in Slovenia. He's going over there to Australia. They're going to do it big time. I can't wait.
Oh, man, it's going to be solid. Then you got the welterweight tournament where you guys like Dean Purdon, Zine Saliba, a host of other great Aussie fighters in the welterweight tournament. Guys we've seen and then guys we haven't seen. Then how about this women's fight? This one's going to be great.
Oh, this is going to be incredible. You're talking about the rematch between Lana, the Black Mamba Kate, and Amy, the Ace Adam. Last time Kate took it by a close split decision. They're going to do it again. It's going to be big time WMMA action down there in Australia.
Oh, I cannot wait for this one. Not to mention the big main event, who we've already talked about, Rusty McBride and Daniel Hooker. It's all going down May 10th. We're going to be there calling all the action. You can catch it on epicenter.tv, afcmma.com.au for even more information. And then finally, this one's coming out of KSW. KSW 22 went down a few weeks back, and some big stories came out of this one. Camille Walloos, Carl Bedorf, the big heavyweights keep their streaks going. Paul Nastula has that storybook return to action, finishing Kevin Asplin in the first. Then how about the main event, Casey? Jan Blachowicz taking on Goran Reljic. I call Reljic. You called Blachowicz, and you called the right fighter. Unanimous decision.
I was so excited about this fight. It was truly trial by fire for Jan Blachowicz, taking on the very tough Goran Reljic, UFC vet. He blasts through it. He wins the unanimous decision victory, and I think the sky is the limit for Jan Blachowicz in the future.
I think you're absolutely right. And just like Mamed Kaladov, Casey, many people are wondering if Jan is going to make that great UFC jump. Our friends at MyMMA.pl caught up with the champion. Check it out.
Jak się czujesz? Super, zadowolony, szczęśliwy, tak się mam czuć. Wiesz, jest na swoim miejscu, to co?
Generalnie oprócz ręki żadnych śladów walki po tobie nie widać, przynajmniej wizualnie. Jak się czujesz, czy są jakieś kontuzje inne?
Tak, ręka, trochę mieszczenka boli w zawiasach, ale tam niedużo, udo troszeczkę i stopa. Ale to takie, wiesz, to normalne, to tak, po cięższym jakimś takim treningu mocniejszym, sparingu, nie?
Plan na walkę w 100% zrealizowany?
No wiesz, chciałem. Fajnie byłoby skończyć przed czasem w końcu, no ale taktyka zagrała tak, jak miała zagrać.
Co myślisz, że będzie bonus za walkę? No, najlepsza na tej gali?
Nie wiem, no to już nie mi oceniać, tylko nie wiem, Martinowi i temu, no fajnie by było i Kawulowi, tak?
A powiedz Janek, predyspozycja Gorana, co powiesz o nim jako zawodniku?
Jest to solidny, wiesz, dobre warunki, odwrotna pozycja walki, no ale co, no Janek był lepszy.
A ile razy Janek poczuł cios Gorana?
Wiesz co, ciężko mi tak mówić, ale chyba ze 3-4 razy mnie trafił tak, że mi takiego flesza w głowie miałem. No nie? Takiego, który by mnie wyłączył czy podłączył tak, żebym na jakimś półnokaucie był, ale takiego, że fajnie. Nie?
Właśnie Goran powiedział, że jesteś gotowy, żeby iść do UFC. Jak ty się zapatrujesz na tę sprawę?
Ja już jestem gotowy, wiesz. Nie no, wiesz, ja się cieszę, że mam pas KSW, że walczę dla KSW. Wiadomo, jakie jest moje marzenie, że chciałbym zawalczyć w UFC. No, też to nie zależy tylko ode mnie. jeżeli będzie taka opcja, Joe Silva się odezwie, to zawalczę. Bardzo bym tego chciał i zobaczymy.
Now, KSW 23 won't go down until June 8th, so we have a little bit of time, but get to confrontasha.com and stay up to date.